What's up, y'all? Welcome to the stream. Today I'm working on controller rumble. I just been looking into the library I use for controllers. The library is called OIS, Object Something Input System. Anyways, it works great for basically every bit of your controller, right? Using your D-pad, your analog joystick key things, your buttons, but controller rumble is pretty lacking. It works on Linux, I think. We're going to find that out today. Anyways, the code is actually written for Linux. The code isn't written for Windows. It doesn't support xInputLib, or it does support xInputLib, but it doesn't support xInputLib's controller rumble yet. So anyways, I might have to write some special code for xInput on Windows and also using IOKit on Mac. But hopefully this works on Linux already so I can get the core of it started today. What's up, Salad? Howdy, man. How's your day going? So I've got, let's get a debug build started. There we go. That'll get a debug build started. But I'm actually going to code using Xcode and all that, and then I'll switch over to Linux and try it. Oh, and I'd want to connect my controller. You've been dead tired all day? Oh, man. I hear you. I get dead tired a lot. All right, yeah, so connect the controller to Linux. All right, so I'm going to use some example code from the OIS library. Where is it at? Demos, there we go. FF demo, yeah, FF console demo. Okay, it's got a whole bunch of code here. But the important stuff, I'm gonna copy over into my input controllers so we can use it for testing out the controller rumble. We'll need all these kind of things, all these variables and variable effects. I probably will not implement the whole, I won't implement it exactly how they're implementing it here, but I want to copy most of their code for now so I can just even test out the controller rumble, because there's a lot to controller rumble. You got to set it all up a certain way, and it's like a continuous thing over time. You're constantly updating the controller rumble variables, so that's why I'm copying most of their code first. Okay, so let's go to input controllers, and I'll start pasting this stuff at the end, I guess, maybe the beginning. Let's put it at the very beginning. Okay, I think I'm gonna need this force variable applier thing. And period variable applier. Perhaps this effect manager. But not the application and not the joystick manager. And not this event handler either. Okay, cool. So I think I'm gonna try and copy this stuff too. What's up, Rocket? What's up, man? You just realized power lines above ground? I know. They built a lot of ours above ground, and then they've realized, oh, it's probably better to put them underground. So a lot more of them lately have been put underground, but still there are some above ground power lines here in our country. What's up, Teak? How you doing? Okay, so I'm still copying some code over. Actually, let's see if we can even compile at this point. All right, we get some bugs, some errors. Yeah, you published it. How's it been going, man? So using some using statements to get rid of these bugs or errors. Quite good for such a niche game. Nice, man. And the reviews are good. Yeah, man. Is it okay, so it's out on Steam? Rocket, that depends on your distro. Yeah, good job, Teak. Yeah, I think on elementary OS it puts it in user, no, not user bin, user lib. It puts it in user lib slash your architecture. So you're probably in user lib x6486. Right on, Teak. Check this out, everybody. Teak published a game to Steam. He got through Greenlight, got his game all coded up. How many platforms are you supporting out here? Yeah, not bin. Bin is where the binaries go. Lib is where the libraries go. Include is where the includes go. Feels so good. Right on, man. Okay, so it requires Windows. That's cool. Nice, man. Oh, the Linux vision was failing? Yeah. Well, you're by supporting Windows, you're supporting like 90-something percent of players. It's like most game companies don't even bother with Mac or Linux versions. Okay, cool. I'm gonna check this out later on. Good job, Teak. I'm proud of you, man. There it is. OIS constant effect, OIS periodic effect. So this is gonna take a minute to get this all coded and working with my controller code and their example code for doing controller rumble. What's up, Lloyd? Oh, right, yeah. Wow, cool. So it's based on the weight of atoms. So if I play your game, does that mean I'm going to learn a bit more about chemistry? Because I've always been interested in atoms and how the hell they connect and stuff like that. Okay, I'm going to start by... It's got some of these... It's got some output. Oh, right. The effect manager, the joystick manager. This effect manager stuff probably is going to need to go inside. I guess actually we can just use do a using C out for now. Even though I'm going to take that out once this gets all coded up. A bit cool. Quantum chromodynamics, cool. Up, down. Wait, are they red, green, blue? What are the chromodynamics again? Is it they have some colors that are associated with quarks, right? Wait, what's the one you use for C out? I never use it. It's not. It's is it standard IO? No, it's not that. It's IO stream. Yeah, pressing F5. Thanks, name guy. Thank you, man. IO stream. I always forget that because I never use it. I have my own log statements. So yeah, what do we got it now? Now it's like complaining about the joystick manager. Okay, so now's the time to take their example code and make it work with my code. So they've got all these basically. So if you're just tuning in, I'm working on controller rumble right now. The way it works is you have to continuously update the controller with new states of your variables, right? So they implemented this example code is coming from a library called OIS. So it's an open source library you can find on GitHub. It's a C++ based controller library. So they use a variable class, which can like hold a general variable. Then there's like a constant, more specific variable, and there's limited variables and triangular variables. And then this a variable effect thing uses an OIS effect object and a map of variables and things like that, and then applies them all. And then they've got an effect manager class, which goes and applies all the effects. So that's what I need to do is integrate this effect manager now into my own code and use it so I can create some effects and try it out. Try and get some controller rumble started today. As I mentioned earlier in the stream when I first started, this only works on Linux because that's just how they wrote their library. They only wrote the Linux part for controller rumble. All the other controller stuff works for all platforms, but the Linux part is the only, or Linux is the only thing that supports the rumble at this point. So once I get this working, I'll need to write some controller rumble code for Windows and Mac. That's assuming that this Linux code actually works. I'm not even sure if it will. So, but if it doesn't work, at least I'll have something in place to try it out once it does work. What's up, Mango? I know, it's totally overkill. Totally is name guy. Complete overkill. So that's why I'm also looking forward to simplifying this. Once I get this integrated into my code, I'll be going through and just hacking away stuff I don't need. That'll be a joy. I love getting rid of code. It's a fun thing. Okay, so we're not using their manager class. And in fact, most of this manager, this effect manager stuff can probably, I guess I could keep it in this class. Deletes entire project. I love it so much. I'm gonna ditch all of these 72,000. It's not even 72, it's like more than that now. 78. 78 and a half almost. Damn, 78,000 lines of code. It's a good thing I ain't smoking as much weed lately. I can remember where everything is now. Like, oh yeah. Where's that code? Oh, I remember it's right there. Okay, so the constructor for effect manager creates effects, adds them into this map vars thing. Yeah, only 5 days of Christmas, right? You don't have to go to your great you don't like going to your grandparents' house? Oh, why's that? Okay, yeah, so the basically this constructor creates some effects and pushes them back into a map. The destructor deletes them all. This update goes through and updates each one of the effects. Check playable effects. This determines which effects can actually be played. The select effect thing, I don't think we're gonna need to do this. Yeah, we don't need to do this at all. Printing effects, debugging on, yeah, okay. This is basically, this entire class is unnecessary. I'm not even gonna use it. Oh, they're not that nice. Oh, dang, you have scars? Oh, wow, man. Dang, sounds scary. Okay, which one of these effects should we try first? The constant force on one axis. Let's do number one. So we don't need a current effect index. Update frequency, maybe. Basically, this is all we need. Let's copy that, the VEC effects into my own controller thing. Let's call this just effects. Oh, you got English grandparents too? Thank you, name guy. I appreciate that. Am I using an engine? Yes, I'm using an engine called Cocos 2DX. A lot of the visuals though you're seeing are all custom shaders and stuff. What's up, Arcane? I'm good, man. I'm good. How are you doing? All right, so we'll comment out this entire class or just delete it. It says map bars. Map bars, what is this used for? Pushes it back. All right. So we do need these and this. But other than that, yeah, that's all we need. Okay. So once we have loaded the controllers, set them up, and we determine that a controller has, or the system has the ability to do force feedback, we're just going to start doing force feedback. Finals coming. Oh no, there's not enough hours in the day. Oh, I know that feeling. That's how I feel almost every day regarding this game. I have so many hundreds of bugs left to finish, and there's so much content still to be added, and there's so little time to get it all done. Okay, so this is going to get pushed back into the effects variable. Yeah, you got finals over. Yes, yeah, there's been a sale on Humble this whole week. Yeah. It's not the it's the Songbringer's pre-order version. I've been trying to sell it. You know, I've always been selling pre-orders of the game to fund the game, basically fund the game's development. So when these Humble sales come up, they're actually really awesome because I can get a lot more sales. But this one, this sale hasn't gone that well. Haven't really got that many sales. I don't know why. I even put all this work into doing a new trailer and doing new screenshots and updating all the information, but it didn't seem to help sales. I don't know why. Maybe it just wasn't a good sale for in general for most developers. I don't know. Or maybe it's just you just have to get featured by Humble or something like that and put on their list. Something like that. Okay, so checking playable effects. Let's skip that. But we do want to update the effects. That's pretty important. And also delete the effects. Let's delete the effects first. Like when we destroy the manager. Loop over the effects. Yeah, the time of year, right? It's like December when there's a lot of other like AAA games coming out, so maybe it's not as good for indies. And they're hard up on cash because most people are already spending on presents, yeah. It was quite a few scrolls down the page. Yeah, see, I probably wasn't even featured. No, it's not for sale yet on Steam, so I can't take advantage of Steam sales. You can't start selling on Steam until your game's actually out, or you do early access. And I've already discussed I'm not going to do early access for Songbringer. I don't think it's a good fit. So anyways, I'm still just going to keep on doing the private closed beta the way it's always been, where people can buy in and play the beta version if they pre-order it from my website via Humble. So anyways, that's going pretty well, you know. I'm not going to try and mess with that at this point. But yes, once the game is finally released, then I can take advantage of the Steam sales and things like that. And I'm sure there's a lot of people that would just prefer to order it there. I would say most people probably are waiting for it to come out on Steam. So that's what I would, if I were a game, you know, if I were waiting for this game, I wasn't the one developing or whatever, I would be waiting for it on Steam because I would prefer to play this game as it's fully finished myself. But some people prefer to play the beta version, and that's cool because y'all are helping me out finding bugs and making suggestions. So this is the variable effect. You're just deleting the variable effect? Okay. Doesn't this pop up as a completion? Is it pair.second? Oh, it's a vector. Oh. Ow. There we go. Now we're deleting the effects. So how do you like Elementary compared to the one you were using the other day? What's that one called? I gotta check that one out. What's that OS called that you were using, that Linux distro? Oh, and this shouldn't be inside this loop. What am I doing? There we go. Okay, so we're now can destroy the manager, which this should happen in the destructor of controllers. I want to make sure. Yeah, cool. It destroys the manager. Nice. Okay, so now we're ready to update all the effects. Solus. Nice. So which one's, so Solus is better or Elementary OS is better? I gotta try this distro out. Having VMware is so awesome. I love VMware. Solus. Oh, you couldn't find a way to install packages? Oh, okay. Well, Elementary uses the regular apt, uses apt, which is the most common package manager. What's up, Kukuriku? Solus is a Linux distro. Elementary OS is also a Linux distro. Yeah, Arch is definitely hands-on, right? Arch is like the most hands-on of all hands-on. I have downloaded Arch. I haven't actually started. I did actually boot it, and I'm like, damn, this is going to be a lot of work. So I don't have time to do Arch right now. But if I did have time, it would be a really fun OS to get all set up exactly how you want it, you know? So it's so customizable like that, or like individualizable, I guess you could say. Set it up exactly how you want it to be. What's the update freak supposed to be? Oh, you create an effect manager that way? All right, so what does it get created with? When it creates the effect manager. End effect update freak. You added this thing called Conky. Oh, sweet. React OS? Yeah, EA Windows, I hear you there. And Turgos? But it's an Arch-based one. I've heard of React OS. Wait, has anybody tried Steam OS? That's another one I have to definitely get on my VMware so I can test the game on Steam OS. Oh, right. React is basically Windows, but open source. Is that right? Is this right? Is that what this is? Holy shit, if that's what this is so dope. I can't wait for this. I wish it would just say that right here. Like, this is what it is. Antergos is like Debian? Oh, SteamOS is just Debian with the Steam Big Picture as its window manager. Okay, so it runs Windows apps natively. Sweet. Wait, so, oh, hold on. Is React OS Debian-based then? What does this mean? This is not Linux mimicking Windows. It was more or less dead. Oh. Oh, man. Mario Bros. You can play Mario Bros. Is this like really old school like this? I love this look. I love the old school look. But is this actually an old website or is this like. Okay, let's check out their Twitter feed, huh? That should be the most up-to-date stuff. They did pin a tweet on November 16th. It looks like they're working on it. They posted a tweet just 3 hours ago. That's cool. Maybe React OS is coming. But it's just slowly. Oh yeah, so yeah, React OS is not a Linux thing then. It's just a total rewrite of the NT kernel. Mint? Do you mean Mint? The fresh maker. Oh. Effect update. 1 hertz. There we go. All right. We don't even need to look at that variable then. Effect update frequency is just 1. All right, cool. We're starting to leak now. The next thing I'll do is get it so we can update these effects. Hey, what's up, Clark? Yeah, looks nice, Rocket. Going good, Clock. Why do I use C++ hater? Why do you use raw pointers instead of smart ones? Because I'm not that smart. No, I'm joking. I don't use smart pointers mostly because I'm lazy. I haven't finally even learned how to use smart ones. But it's more because of what it would have to do to my entity component system. So I looked at writing my whole entity component system using smart pointers, and I would have to rewrite so much code to use smart pointers that it's just not worth it. Maybe the next game. Okay, so check playable effects. This is really, this might not even be necessary, but this update active effects, this is necessary. This needs to happen on a constant basis, so we'll put this in the tick update. Not refresh. Where's this update at? Pre-tick will work. Update the effects. Nice salad. Is that really what yours looks like? That explains why games leak. If you write leaky code, yeah. Just because you're using smart pointers doesn't mean your game's not going to leak. And just because you aren't using smart pointers doesn't mean your game is going to leak. Okay, so we loop over each effect. If effect is active, effect update, and get the current force feedback device. It's just basically I guess what does that mean? I guess we're only gonna have one controller at first, so if FF0 modify effect get FF effect. All right, for testing purposes, it looks like we got most of the things created. I wonder if this is gonna work. Yeah, right, smart pointers do have overhead. Yep, you should use prefix incrementers, but I'm not even using an incrementer here. Okay, so let's see if this even works. Unique pointer has no overhead, but it's still a class, and you still have to call functions. You saw one? Where? Where was it? All right, so this example code I've just been copying over obviously has some warnings and stuff like that. If this is something I'm actually going to use, I'll update it to not have warnings. I hate warnings. I don't like having warnings on Windows or Linux or Mac. Right, the mental overhead of template syntax. Compile time overhead, too. It's true. But unique pointer, doesn't it incur a function call as well? So like to access your unique pointer, aren't you having to call a function? I mean, and I'm not saying in release mode, but in debug mode when you've got like all your inline functions disabled, wouldn't a unique pointer still incur a function overhead call? Okay, let's see if we're, while that's compiling, I want to see if we need to use this if effect is available type code or here. Oh, we might need to select the effect. Ah, here we go. So we want to upload the effect to the device or whatever. That's probably something it's totally missing it right now. Yeah, so we do need to call this. This is effects.back set active true. And this is FFI what are we calling here? Upload. Unique pointer calls a destructor and deletes the object whenever you lose. Right. Unique pointer is just a pointer? It is? I thought it was a class that wrapped itself around a pointer. I don't even know. I'm not that experienced with smart pointers. I've never really used them. What am I working on? I'm working on controllers today. So I'm working on Controller Rumble. I've got my Xbox controller out, and I've looked at all the code for how the Rumble works. And it basically only works on Linux with the library I'm using here. So I'm going to test it out first with Linux and get it all going. And if it works on Linux, that's cool. And then I'll have to go back and write some code for Mac using IOKit and also on Windows using Xinput to get the Rumble to work for all platforms. So there, we've uploaded the effect and set it to be active. That was probably pretty critical right there. And also, is there something that has to be done with... We just selected the effect, basically. Oh, checking playable effects? Here, so this is listing all the what's playable. Should probably do that and like step through that code or print it or something. Why am I starting with Linux? I just explained that. So basically, the code, the library I'm using is OIS, and it's kind of ancient in ways. Basically, they didn't finish the code for the other platforms. So the only platform that I saw that works for Controller Rumble is Linux. So that's where I have to start. And I get it working on Linux, then I can go back and write the code for Mac and Windows. So this is looping over the effects and looping over it sees if it's even okay. So once again, we just need to go auto effect in effects. Gosh, man, this code for this library is C++ 98 everywhere. So it's kind of annoying to have to go and update it all to like C++ 11. Will you support Xbox One Rumbles too? Yeah, totally. Yeah, Xbox One, PlayStation controller Rumble, all that. So we go auto eForce. FFI supports effect. Oh, this should all be in, this should all be in the dump function. So yeah, we'll just push back the new effect, set it to be active, upload it, and then go to dump. If the force feedback is not null. Oh, see, I already do this. I list these supported effects right here. So this just loops over each one. I guess this. Nah, this might not even be necessary. Let's come with this out for now. All right, cool. Make sure it still compiles on Mac. And then compile it on Linux and try it out. Oh, you're asking if it will use the additional rumble motors in there. I guess so. I mean, I haven't written the code yet for the Xbox One or whatever, but yeah, I mean, I don't see why not. Okay, we got some unused variables. Just two warnings. All right, we're good to go. Let's try this out. Big run. So I just set it to run the code all the time, so it's just going to rumble the whole time if it is working. It might not even be working. What is happening? Nothing's happening. Either that, it's just taking forever to load. What's up, code? What are you doing? Let's start checking the log, I guess. Looks like it's hanging. Yeah, no, not this one. What's this one? This one's a release. There we go. Mount song. This is the one. All right. What do we got? Terminate call after throwing an instance of OS. Oh. Unknown error creating effect. Oh, what? Unknown error creating effect. Setting master gain. Exception raise the joystick creation. Okay, so it threw an exception. That's why it's just hanging here. And it's probably, yeah, it's hanging in GDB right here. Okay, so I need to be editing this in a window to start with. So let's set the Linux settings. Window size to be something small, like 420p, maybe 30 frames a second. Let's do that again just to make sure that we can see the error this time. Am I gonna add support for this controller? What controller is this? Potato her! Yeah! That's awesome! Each one of those is a button. If it uses a regular controller interface, then my code already supports it. Revolutionary Spud technology! Okay, so now I can see that there's a SIG abort. But why am I not catching that? I thought I was supposed to catch this stuff. Isn't there a try in here? Yeah, set up controllers. Oh, okay, it already did catch this. But why does it like crashes or something like it? Terminate called after throwing an instance of. Oh, did I trap errors in the? I don't know. I'm not gonna go too deep into this, trying to get all the error handling perfect right now. I want to get the rumble working. So what's happening is it's unknown error creating effect. Damn it. Unknown error creating effect. That's a crappy error to get. So let's see where it's actually getting it. All right, I'll set a breakpoint here. This is line 824. Oh, it outputs the keyboard? Oh, nice. Yeah, the actual escape keys. Yeah, I've got mine remapped to caps lock now, thanks to that. Okay, I need a refresher on GDB debugging. Forget how to debug a GDB. You set a breakpoint. I think using B. Oh, it's break. That's right. Whoops. Damn. Where we at? Where we at? Eight. Let's try 819. You use it a lot? What do you use caps lock for? All right, cool, we're at the breakpoint. All right, so how do I step again? GDB step into. Oh, it's just step. Oh, wait, next is, I think, is the one I want. Ah, next. Okay, so there's next and there's step. I want to use next at this point. Cool. Okay, so we can set the master gain. Set auto center mode. That's no problem. Oh, I can just press enter and does the same thing. That's cool. Okay, so it can create the effect too, it looks like. Oh, you hit caps lock instead of shift. There we go. Okay, so there's the problem. Uploading it. As soon as it tries to upload the effect, it dies. But this could be because I haven't actually created the effect variable. This get FF effect thing. Let's figure that out. Get FF effect. So this is when a variable effect. Oh, you pass it a P effect. And it assigns it. And then you just get it. Okay, so I have to pass it that, which means I probably created it. Yeah, FFI shouldn't be null. Should be null because that's like one of the first things it checked here. This is the thing when you use somebody else's code, you don't know how things work at first. But that's the whole point of today. I'm just trying to get my feet wet with the whole controller rumble thing. Once I understand how this all works, then I can go and actually make all this code beautiful and stuff. So this is where it creates a new effect. Oh, right there. This is the effect right here. And then when you create the triangle variable or the new variable effect, it passes the P effect. And then that shouldn't be null. So let's go just auto E for effect or whatever for now. We'll get the effect and then assert that they're equal. And assert is not null. And then upload it. So that's just assuming, if as long as this all works, then the problem has got to be in this upload function. Should have used Unity. Is upload virtual? Probably, knowing the way this library is written. It's, I'll have to look that up a little bit later. Yeah, so that'll be the next step, right? Stepping into their actual code, figuring out what's up with it. I can just step into the upload function. Oh, in fact, before I run the next time, I'll set the breakpoint at just the right place. So we want to set a breakpoint right here, 8:58. What's this? Deleting object polymorphic class variable which is a non-virtual destructor. Oh. So, see what I'm saying? This is some old-ass C++ code here. This OIS library. They didn't make their destructor virtual. Is that the one that's talking about, though? Variable. Oh no, that's just variable. So variable class. Oh, it never did a destructor. Give me a break, really? Hopefully this makes GCC happy. Happy, happy, happy. Ugly code, so ugly. Don't avert your eyes. Don't look at this. Yeah, it was Sigabort, right? If it had gotten a null pointer? Really? It would? I didn't know that. What? What did I do? Huh? Potato Chip! What's up, Mr. Frederick? Hey, man! I'm just writing some, well, I'm writing some controller code today. Oh, this is just constant, constant variable. Oh, see a board on a pure call? Okay. Oh, really? On a pure virtual call? Really? Okay, let's actually check that out right now then. I'm gonna check out where's that source OIS. It may actually be, it may totally be, you might be totally right. Like it might actually be just that they didn't even write Linux code, but Linux was the only thing that reported itself as if it did have functions it could execute. Let's look at its upload function and see what it does. See, this is looking to me like they wrote, yeah, see, it's got it. And we're using the constant for, no, this is, yeah, this is upload. Yeah, this should work. Unless update constant effect is not written or something. Oh, and modify also uploads the effects. I didn't even need to call it at first. Yeah, here's the update constant effect function. Okay. All right, well, it should compile now. Let's see what happens. You're banging your head against the wall? You got your sprites to cast receive shadows? Oh, nice, man. Good job. Yeah. Wait, so those are sprites as in billboards, like 3D billboards? Oh, wait, I can scroll. I see. Oh, no, no. Okay, so they're not. Nice job, man. Yeah. Kick ass, Mr. Frenick. Oh, I didn't set the breakpoint. Whoops. See if it asserted at all. Okay, we'll set a breakpoint. What's that line again? A66. So this time I'm going to try stepping into the upload function if everything else is looking good. Oh, can you print the contents of a variable? You can. I'm sure you're sure you can. How do you GDB print contents of variable? How do you do it? P is just a P function? Oh yeah, P. It's just P. P! Optimized out my ass! What? Well, it didn't fail. Didn't fail. There's that. Oh, that makes sense. But I thought OIS exception, I was writing this all, this is all supposed to be inside. This is inside setup controller, which is inside a try block. Setup controllers. I'm calling try and then calling setup controller. And I've got a cat, I am catching the OIS exception. So I don't think it's that. Yeah, it's not doing that. So set active works. Let's go step into step. All right, so we're in the upload function. Linux force feedback line 139. Which is up here. Switch effect force. Step. 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 Now we're in the update constant effect thing. Get force effect. Set common properties. Oh man, this would be so much easier if they had written this for Mac. I could debug in my normal environment and this could have been solved at least 10 seconds ago. What's up, Beach Knee? How empty my dock is? This thing? Yours has five times as much stuff? Nice. I try and throw away stuff I don't need as often as possible, or I'm not using. Yeah, Mr. Frenick. I can't wait to play your game, man. Update constant. Set common properties. Let's try and step over that. Yeah, so that worked. I bet you it's in here in this upload function. We step in here. Get the list of effects. Oh, this could be it. It might not even be an effect that it can do. I bet this is it. Yeah, we stepped in there. Oh, this thing? Oh, this is Linux. This is my Linux dock, which is of course very minimal. Yeah, it's not VMware. This is Linux. This is elementary OS. Yeah, the fire mages guys, totally. Yeah, they're hard, aren't they? They're meant to be hard, but they are maybe a little bit too hard. There's some balancing left to do. There, are you talking about when there's a bunch of them in one room, or are you talking about when there's like just three or four of them, or two or something? I haven't even run the game yet today. Just working on the controller rumble. Actually, I spent 5 hours this morning replying to a single email. Took forever. I was fixing bugs during it, and there was just a ton of stuff, this ton of feedback. It's all good feedback though, stuff that I had to face, but man, it's good to get that. It's really good to hear what people's gripes are in a video game, you know, because a lot of people won't even tell you what their gripes are. They'll play the game, they'll be like, ah, I didn't really like this one thing, but then they won't tell you that. It's a rare person that will play a game and tell you everything about their experience, all their gripes, all the things they like too. And all it's sometimes it's those gripes that really are the most important things you can get as feedback from players. So I'm really thankful to that person for sharing everything all straight up to me. So great. Yeah, I honestly should probably am like seek that kind of feedback from people more, but sometimes, you know, I've already got freaking 200 bugs left to finish, so I'll do that later. Bugs and so many features left to even implement, so okay, so we're creating the effect. Okay, this is oh, this is just checking if the effect already existed. This is creating the effect now. Oh, we could have done this here. OIS Linux debug. So we're trying to create the effect by using IO control. Oh, there it is. There's our bug. Unknown error creating effect. Maybe the device is full. And this is the first effect that we're trying to create. So the device shouldn't be full. So what is this function? What is it supposed to do? I guess maybe I was wrong. Maybe Linux isn't working yet. This library. Yeah, okay, so it's where there's a bunch of them in that tight space. I think I know what you're talking about. I've got that on my list. Let me make that Trello item a lot more higher priority. Oh, is that why I did? Oh, thanks, man. Yeah, this library spells joystick with a capital S. Okay, I guess that's an appropriate value, 17. Oh, I guess M joystick is an IO control thing, which is like a handle, like a Linux handle or whatever. Control device. Oh, so it's opened as like a file. You like the challenge? You liked it? I think it should be a little bit more easy though. I think I've got that on my list already. Yeah, I guess not. Maybe not. Let's just add another one. That room is pretty damn difficult. Even if you have cactuses and bombs, like... All right. Well, damn it. If this code, so basically where I'm at here with this is I wanted to do controller rumble today. I just wanted to get it tested out, but it looks like the Linux code, at least it's either I don't have my this version of elementary OS hasn't been set up for Xbox controllers. Or else this code actually doesn't work yet. I don't know. Ah. Which means it's going to be either I start with IOKit on Mac. I guess I should investigate this situation just a little bit more before I quit on this just yet. So I know that it's enumerating the features of the device at some point. So let's get to that bit. Yeah, it does detect the controller. The controller works fine. You can totally play the whole game with the controller, no problem. It's just that when we're doing these effects, like a special effect, like a force feedback, like controller rumble. That's where it's failing. I think it's just this upload function. And so if I comment that out, and then run it again, it should allow the code to get to the point where it's printing out what effects are available. And then yeah, so we can see like it'll look like this or something. Oh, it doesn't have it yet, but we'll see it right here. It'll show the controller. It'll show how many buttons it has. It'll show like how many axes it has, and then it'll show the force feedback results. And I remember seeing something before where it was like it had the ability to do constant force feedback effects, but it didn't have something else. So I just want to get it so the code prints that out first. And it might be this variable effect thing. Because we're using a triangle, or we're also using a triangle effect. Whoops. Like, it might actually be the type of effect. Like, maybe it can do a constant effect, but it can't do variable effects or something like that. It's always a hard thing when you're diving into new territories. This is a totally new territory for me, this controller rumble thing. I've never ever tried to do code for a controller rumble. I don't even know really how it works. So this is a difficult area to be in. Oh, it looks like it crashed again, but that's this time did it crash elsewhere? Oh wait, yeah, I knew it was gonna crash, but I wanted to see this. I want to see what it prints out. Yeah, see that? It says it can do square, triangle, and sine, but it has -1 axes. That's the thing I'm worried about. You ran into scaling issues with your game sprites? You want to resize them or begin a new project? Ew, interesting. Nice, yeah. Good idea to start in the demo. Right on. So I'm kind of worried about this bit right here. It's reporting -1 axes for the force feedback. But it is reporting that it's got these effects that it can do. Let's try and get a little bit deeper into these effects and see which ones are... Like, there's this one bit of code here where it was... What was it doing? It was checking if the effect was playable. So I'll dump when it's dumping out all the controller valve stuff. I'll see if this if each effect is playable. Oh, I already did that here. Okay. So we're just going to print out the results from this. Where was it that was printing that out again? Print effect. Oh, the get description. All right, cool. Context switching. Too much of it. All right, let's see what that prints out. So the device, is the device a negative one ID? No, I think that's actually, it's a good question. Oh, you're right. Yeah, you're right. It is returning a negative one for the device ID. Huh. I wonder what that means. Because I know this works, right? I know I've played, you know what, we should just verify that. I'm not sure if I have actually played with the controller in Linux on VMware. It might just be VMware. It might be that I need to like reboot into Linux to actually get this to work. There's been a couple cases of Windows code where it didn't work the same in the virtual machine. So yeah, that'll be the next thing I test. I'll cut out all this code and see if it actually. See that? It doesn't support any of the effects. But here it says that it can do square, triangle, and sine. So maybe that's the key. Maybe the effect that I just tried. I was just copying over their stuff blindly. Maybe it's not actually using square or triangle or sine. Maybe it's using like something else. Wait, how many spaces is it put there? Yeah, there's only one space. Okay, before I do that though, I will check and see if it's not, if we don't even use the effects at all, we're not even trying to use controller rumble, does it even support the controller? I should check that first thing. I'm not sure if I've even tried this. I know I've played with the controller on my actual Linux distro on the other partition on my hard drive, but I'm not sure if I've tried the controller here in the virtual box or in the virtual machine. Because that could be it. It could just be that the device is totally not even working. Oh yeah, it's not working. Either it's not found. Oh, it just wasn't bound. What? Did it skip left? What the hell? What? Mm-hmm. It looks like the axis is totally wrong. Or something's wrong with the axis controller. I mean... Let's try the D-pad. Okay, yeah, the D-pad's totally rock solid. I think something was wrong with the axis there. Okay, yeah, so I can get the D-pad working. I'm not sure what was up with the axis, though. Okay, so yeah, the controller works. There's probably an issue with the axis, either it might be just VMware. But that's a huge sign that maybe there is some kind of issue here with it running inside of VirtualBox, because I know this worked perfectly, and I didn't even have to manually bind the controls when I tested my other Linux distro on my other partition. So, okay. Anyways, yes, the controller is working. It is connected. Okay, I should explore this a little bit more, but not too much more. The next clue has got to be right here in this. It lists the effects that it's supporting, and then the effect that we tried to create looks like it was not actually supported. So there's got to be a clue in there. So we call this function called getSupportedEffects, and then loop over all those things that it says it supports. Let's figure out what it's actually doing there. getSupportedEffects. Which is not even in here. Oh, it's just M supported effects, which is what? How many distros do you support? Officially, I only support Ubuntu, but it works on a lot of distros. But so far, I've only tested Ubuntu, Kubuntu, Lubuntu, Elementary. Basically, I've only tried Debian flavors. Oh, I've tried what's the GNOME one? Oh, I tried SUSE. So yeah, it works on SUSE as well. But yeah, I definitely got to try SteamOS and make sure it works there. And anybody that writes me in like is like, hey, I'm using this distro and it's not working, I'll definitely try and help them get it. I'll try and get the game to work on their distro too. Okay, so supported. So it's in add effect types. Oh, there's also a range on this force thing. Slackware and FreeBSD? BIOS? When? Potato OS? Haiku? Really? Haiku is BIOS? Huh. Wow. I never knew BIOS continued. Why'd they just change, why'd they change the name, huh? Okay, they just stick with BIOS. BOS, whatever you call it. That's why you name your operating system Haiku. Brotato OS. Okay, so basically, I think the Linux force feedback is going to have to call this add effect types thing. Maybe it's not even doing that. How are you even getting? Oh, this is in Linux event helpers. Oh, it's when it's enumerating the force feedback. OS2? Oh, because B went out of business. Is that really what it was? They had an error message, it was a haiku. What's up, Rocket? So okay, so the it looks like it calls this enumerate force feedback function once it's enumerated or whatever. Oh yeah, this is the problem. Okay, so we've got it, all these kinds of effects, right? There's constant effect, ramp, spring, friction, square, triangle, sine. It's reporting that it's supporting or supporting a square, triangle, sine. What else? Just square, triangle, and sine. And we're trying to use a constant effect, I believe. So there's the problem. Let's try and use a square effect only or something. Wait, we got a triangle, right? Let's just use the triangle. Is it using a constant? Or we're using constant force and the effect type is constant. Oh, so we don't, yeah, that's gotta be it. Is there some other examples that aren't using those? Constant, 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 constant. Periodic triangle, here's one. Try this one out. You can't use your Dutch account? Why not? All right, let's hope this works. So this is using, instead of a constant effect, it's using a triangle effect, which it says that it supports. Cross your fingers. See if this works. I don't understand how this all works because I haven't really played with it yet, but I'm playing with it now. This is where it all begins, right here. Diving into code, you have no idea what's going on. We're diving into the deep end today. We have no idea how cold the water is. But actually, now we can pretty tell the water is kind of cold. The water's cold. You need a wetsuit. Putting on wetsuits is hard, isn't it? Come on. Oh, yeah. Oh! Wait, no. I had this stuff commented out. Damn it. We gotta update it now. It's working! Oh, it's freaking working! It's vibrating! Oh, yeah! So I have to basically quit the game to get this to stop. Hopefully it stops. Come on, tell me it's gonna stop. Yeah, and it stopped even! Oh, yes! It works! I can't believe it works, but it works. Oh, it's so awesome. All my worries have been alleviated. Now I can start cleaning up code and stuff. Right on. So the question is, so triangle works, right? Yeah, this is awesome. So we got square, triangle, or sine. Which basically means when it enumerates what kind of effects it can use, that's when my code should say, okay, I'm going to use squares, or I'm going to use triangles, or I'm going to use sines. So the code I write here has to be flexible enough to, like, use any one of these. Oh, and check this out. Yeah, it listed the periodic force on one. Oh, this is just the description from the example. Okay. Oh, this is great. This is such a great first step. I mean, even though it's like really ugly code, all this stuff copied in from this demo from the library, at least it works. And now I can see that it does work. So yeah. All right, the first thing I'm gonna do is make it a little smarter here about which force feedback device it's updating. The effect doesn't, so the effect will actually have, wait, you've got effect update? Variable effect set active, is active, update, Wait, can an effect actually look up what force feedback device it's already connected to? Let's see. OIS effect. So you can get the specific force effect. But no, it doesn't look like you can look up whatever device it's associated with. So let's add it. Some code we can delete. See, it'd be nice to really get all this code in the same place. So I'm not like constantly going back and forth between different stuff too. Let's move this like somewhere more appropriate. We shouldn't need IO stream anymore. What's up, Grimly? Welcome to the stream, man. Cool, we didn't need that or that. Okay, maybe the next thing to do would be to start understanding what's the difference between a triangle effect and all, and what's the difference between a triangle effect, square effect, sine effect, and all those. What's this game about? It's like imagine if the original Zelda game was procedurally generated, and it's basically like that. It's like if imagine the very first Zelda game. Remember that? And if you could play a different Zelda game each time, that's kind of what this is about. So when you start an adventure in this game, I could just show you. That is running again. The sound working for you guys? Nice, cool. Looks like we got sound. All right, so it's like Zelda 1 basically, but you enter six letters when you start a game. So the six letters gives you an entire world. Right? So whatever six letters you enter, that generates an entire world, so whatever. Or less. Basically, it'll generate an entire world based on that six-letter word right there, and then you can play the exact same world again if you just enter the same world code, or you can play a different world. Here's one world seed called Hyrule, and it's basically there's like an overworld. There's 10 different dungeons. It's a lot like Zelda 1. It's also meant to have the openness feeling of Zelda 1. where you could go to pretty much any dungeon. At first, you could play the play them out of order. Oh, this is an interesting world. It's got two dungeons right next to each other. So there you go. Okay, so now let's start learning more about how these different effects work. For example, this one worked, this triangle periodic force. But what's the difference between a periodic force and a constant force? Here's one being created with a constant force. It also has a direction. Trigger button. We're never going to use trigger button. Trigger interval. Replay length. Okay, yeah, we want it to continue forever until we stop it. No maxis. This is exactly the same setup. It's just that this one is in a periodic force and this one's a constant force. Oh, but the big thing is that's different here is that it's const force thing. Oh. Yeah. This thing here. This is kind of a crazy way to code it. So they made it so that this effect class has a variable inside it. Let's look at that. Each OIS effect object has a pointer to a base class, force effect. So it has a force effect pointer. And a force effect can be like a constant effect or a constant effect, a ramp effect, a periodic effect, a conditional effect. But then, so let's see if that still works if we do a constant effect. Oh, it probably won't, because we already know that effect constant doesn't work with this controller. Yeah, Grimly, it does. Yeah. So I've written this game in C++ with a game engine called Cocos 2DX. So basically, I write all my game code, all like 78,000 lines of code is all written in cross-platform. You know, it's independent of what platform you're running it on. So yeah, you can compile it in Visual Studio. You compile it here in Xcode. On Linux, I compile it in GCC. And it runs on all these platforms because Cocos 2DX has the layers of platform-dependent code all set up for me. All right, Ichni, we'll see you, man. Hope you get some good rest, man. Constant's a constant speed of the rumble motor. Yeah, it's probably right. Triangle increases linear to max and then back down. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yes, Cocos 2DX is free. So it's not as well. I could go and just check. I could try and create a like a square effect. But first, I want to understand this whole periodic force versus constant force thing. Oh, the game. No, the game's not free. It will never be free. But can you compile it in Q Basic? Nope, can't compile it in Q Basic. All right, let's start cleaning this up a little bit and play around with different effects. So, Grizzgrass, Rip, what's up? Is the stream all right? Or are you talking about Rip, like you'll play it if it's free, that's a rip? Okay, so now that there's this, let's try a different kind of effect. It's the same thing with the periodic effect, but this time we'll do an effect square. Periodic force. Magnitude, offset, phase, period. I wonder what else these have. Periodic effects. Gotta look this up a bit. So many comments. Oh, there's no, this is, I'm not using, this isn't my code. This is demo code. I've copied all this demo code over from this. I'm diving into some crazy territory here. I don't understand any of this. So I'm just trying to like, this is why it looks so dirty. Super dirty code because it's not mine. This isn't how I would write it. Magnitude, offset. You could tell I have an ego about code, huh? Right? I have my own particular way I want my code to look. I want code to look beautiful, and this does not look beautiful to me. What's up, game? Hope the game's improved. It probably has since you've seen it. It's dirty, naughty, nasty code. Yeah, you're just like it works. It's with the bad crowd. That's right. So, can there be a square variable? Nope. So, they didn't even write code for the square variable. There's a limited variable. Maybe that's what that's supposed to be. Skips cigarettes and smokes class. Ah. maybe it's limit. Yeah. Triangle. Gosh, man. This code. Oh, triangle is a limited variable. Okay, we need to write a little square variable. If we're gonna do it this guy's way, we gotta do it this guy's way. So we'll try out a square, and then we'll also do a sine wave thing, just to see what these things all feel like. Init value, delta value, min, max. Okay, so each one of these variables moves itself over time, but it's always moving by a constant value. So that's one of the things I'll do once I get this integrated with my code, is I'll make the delta value based on the tick and the actual time elapsed rather than just some constant value. We need two kinds of values here, not the, just the delta value, but also, let's say like a current value or something.
Going to my appointment.
See you, baby. Okay, so the current value starts with the init value. And then so we set the current value to be the D value, and we'll set it to be a square by making it round to the nearest one. Good for you, Grimly. Doesn't matter where you're starting. So if the difference, so to implement like a square rounding, we could say if the difference between the delta value of we need to use fabs of the value minus limited variables, min, what the hell is this called? It sucks using other people's code. I don't like naming things with underscores. So if that d value minus min is greater than, or is actually less than, the max value, then we're going to use the min value. Otherwise, we use the max value. Okay, so there, we've got a square variable class now. We need a whole class for that? I don't think so. Squaw! New squaw! New square! Square variable! Yay! Which takes what again? An init value, a delta value, a min, and a max. Basically, it's the same thing as this triangle. Init. Delta, min, max. All right, so we're using effect square, and now we've got a new variable all set up. So it's using a square variable over a periodic thing. Let's see if that works. Okay, compiles on Mac. Do I know C sharp? No, I do not. Sorry. All right, so we know that a triangle variable works. That's awesome. And it felt like triangle is actually a pretty good one to use if you're going to do rumble, right? Because triangle just means that it's going to rumble like that. Like it's just going to, the motor is going to go like da 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 with a linear value between two things. Square, I'm imagining, could be really chaotic because it's going to use a maximum value. Let's see if this works. Yeah, it works. But it feels almost exactly the same as the triangle. That was weird. Seriously, that felt almost exactly the same. Yeah, let's do a little effect type. Yeah, they do. Oh, okay. Huh. Uh-huh. Yeah. Because this is going to need to be really flexible code here. Like, it needs to use a triangle sometimes. It needs to use a square sometimes. It needs to use a sine sometimes. Why would you use C++ when assembly is lower level? Good point. Touche. Okay, so now we can have... Here, let's do a string description too. Why would you code in assembly when machine language is lower level? Because writing cross-platform code in assembly is torture? Oh my God, right? Can you imagine? Okay, so if we're doing the effect type square, there's an ef square effect. Else, if it's a triangle, do something like that. Okay, I'm starting to get a feel for how I'll eventually rewrite this and make it cleaner and nicer. Basically, we'll have to enumerate the what effects are available. And then pick one based on what the preference of the game is, right? So let's say it prefers the triangle, but if it doesn't have the triangle, then it can use the square. If it doesn't have the square, it can use the sine or whatever. So now let's implement a sine wave. Why would you code machine language when you do your own electronic circuits? Yeah, C++ is not that low level, but it is compared to. Oh gosh, we could go in circles all night about this, huh? Manually enter each bit into CPU registers by soldering a wire to it and then chewing on said wire. All programming is a Rube Goldberg machine. What is a Rube Goldberg machine again? I don't know what those are. Okay, so I'll need to implement a sine variable now to test that out. Sine variable, limited variable. Let's just inherit stuff from other stuff. That's the oop way. Start with an init value. It's got a delta value, a min, and a max. Same thing. Delta value, current value. So current, we'll do the same thing as this. We have a current value that increases over time and stuff. And then the actual value it uses is a sine wave on the d value. So the d current value equals something something. And then the d value equals sine f, or it's just sine actually on the d value. There, sine done. Why would you use electricity when you can read a book? You will change the universe by screaming at rocks. How would I make an if statement check if a number of variables equal to another number of variable in C sharp? Pretty sure it's just use equals equals. Oh yeah, I've seen this XKCD. Classic, classic. The control X modifier C modifier butterfly. A good one. I just finally subscribed to XKCD on Twitter. I didn't know they had a Twitter, and I was like, oh, they got the Twitter. Yes. Twitter it up. Tweet to me. Tweet to me, XKCD. Tweet to me at night. Tweet to me in the morning. Whisper your tweets in my ear. Okay, let's try this out. I'm switching the effect type to sine. Cross your fingers. Let's hope it works. I can ditch all this stuff now. Ditch. Okay, compiling on Linux, running on Linux. Let's see if this works. Just wait until Emacs sends terminators back in time to murder you. Face the fact you aren't good at programming until you go with the lowest level ever and build your own infrastructure from bottom up. It's true. I didn't build this computer. I need to build my own computer. It's not very low level at all. You know what? And that's kind of cheating. It's totally cheating if you can build your own computer from scratch, like even like making your own metals. Like I'll go out and have to like mine my own metals, boil them down, build my own computer. But even that's cheating, right? Because I can look at like information. So I have to I have to like look up, not look up any information, like figure out how to melt my own metals. Okay, it's vibrating again. This time it feels exactly like the other ones too. The sine, the triangle, and the square, they all feel exactly the same. Let's mess with the variables a little bit more this time though. Let's try some like different values for I don't know, these numbers and stuff here. At first, I should understand what the hell this period force is. Oh, this is a Rube Goldberg machine? Oh, one of those? Oh, okay, a Rube Goldberg machine. It's like, it's like one of those physics games. Rube Goldberg machines are awesome. I didn't know that was the name for those. So this is the Guinness Book of World Records for one of them? What? Awesome. Go basketball. Dude, this is the third wall already. So many levers. Holy crap. There's another wall. Oh crap, this thing is 5 minutes long. Holy crap, it's still going. I'm like skipping over minutes worth of this. Wow, that's one I should check out later. It reminds me of that game Mousetrap. Do you guys remember that game? Mousetrap? Do you know if it's possible to get rid of the tab bar in the Pantheon terminal? The tab bar in the Pantheon terminal. Oh, this? Oh, I don't know. Is there some kind of options or something? How do you even? I don't even know. I don't know, Rocket. I'm sure there is. In Linux, you can do pretty much anything. If worst case scenario, you could just modify its source code and then recompile it. Mining metals, you're not really doing it until you create a star and make it turn hydrogen and helium into heavier elements. Good point, Salad. God, it would be totally cheating to go mine your own metals. Gosh. Mousetrap, right? That's why you're making games because of Mousetrap? That's great. Okay, so today's been a pretty much a success. All I wanted to do was to try out some force feedback code, some controller rumble, and it works. And I've learned a few things too. I've learned that basically all the effects feel about the same. So, and I've learned that when I go and make this code cleaner, basically I need to do it based on what effects are available. So when it enumerates the device, it'll like list out, okay, this device supports, for example, on Linux, it supports square waves, triangle waves, and sine waves. So I'll need to pr have a preferred type of wave or whatever, and then variable, and then use the right preferred variable, but still support them all. And then all I need to do is create effects. Whenever I want to do a force feedback, like I want to make the controller rumble, I need to push back a new effect. So there'll need to be something in like input.h when I'm writing, when I actually implement this all in my own game's code, I'll go and like do like new rumble or like rumble for about this much of time, you know? And then inside input controllers, it'll create a new effect. It'll create a, you know, preferred variable type. It'll set it to run for a certain duration. It'll be smarter about how it updates because it'll be using my game's tick. So it'll know how much time has elapsed per tick. And that's basically it. So that'll be, so the first thing to do will be to clean it all up so it works and looks nice, but works with my game engine. And then the second thing to do is I got to go implement this for Mac. So there's no code yet written for Mac and controller rumble. So I'll need to implement that. And then I also need to implement it on Windows, which actually will be the first thing I do is Windows, because 90% of people are using Windows. So yeah, I got to look at XInputLib and figure out how to enumerate its effects and apply effects and all that stuff. But luckily, there's some Linux code here, and the Linux code is working. So I can kind of use all that as an example. So yeah. So once again, I'm using this library called OIS. I know I'm a fake programmer because I'm using other people's libraries. But anyways, this library is kind of ancient. The last time they updated it was like 2011, and they didn't finish all the force feedback stuff. So that's why I got to go and write some more stuff for the, you know, the different platforms. But good. You know what? Let's run it one last time because that was freaking awesome. Let's set it back to the triangle wave. And it's just going to run a triangle wave the entire time the game is running. But I want to do it one last time because it's so satisfying to see your code kind of work. Yeah. Who use Arch Linux only? Don't make games for these people. All right, Xbox controller, vibrate away. I wonder if the PlayStation controller works. Ooh, let's try that actually. Before I go, I'll try the PlayStation controller as well. And the Xbox One controller, I gotta crack that thing out. And the Steam controller, I gotta get this all working with all these controllers. This is kind of a neat thing. Yay! It's vibrating. You know what else this could be used for? That's right. Pleasuring your lady. Or yourself, I guess. Alright, okay, let's try out the PlayStation controller. I don't know if it works or what. We'll see. Wow, so it's good. Ah, oh, man, just to think, like, it's always like that when you start something new and you think, oh, I don't know if I'm going to be able to even do this today. Like, I was, for a while there during this whole stream, I was like, I don't think this is even going to work. I don't think I'm going to be able to have force feedback today. But it eventually worked. Hoorah. Oh, I don't think this controller can be powered from this USB on my keyboard thing. Let's try it. Plug straight into the computer. So wait, it's like a quark, right? It's an up quark or it's a down quark. What kind of quark is this USB? There, oh, there we go. Nice. Okay, let's run it. Do you have force feedback? PlayStation controller on Linux. I don't even know if the PlayStation controller works on Linux. Oh, it does! And it vibrates! cool. Oh, this one has a definitely a different sound to its motor. That's cool. Awesome. Yay! Another one works without doing too much more. Let's see what kind of effects it supports. And even its auto bindings work. That was sweet. Once again, it's got a device ID of negative one, which is kind of weird, but at least it works. Yeah, green skin, this is a virtual machine. This is a Mac I'm running on, but I'm actually running Linux in a virtual machine so I can test out some code, which only works on Linux at this point. It will eventually work on other platforms, but I got to write some code for those platforms. All right, so what effects does it support? Once again, square, triangle, and sine. Same thing. Okay. Cool. Well, good to know it works. Let's try out. Okay, before I go, I'll try out the Xbox One controller too. Got my Xbox One controller. See what happens. Does it work? I don't know. Let's see. But that's the last controller I'm trying today. Because I need to get some freaking dinner. It's time to get some dinner in my belly. Eat some food. Yeah. Put it in my belly. Yeah, that's up, that's down. Okay. Get in your hole. All right, connect to Linux. Let's try this out on Linux. Xbox controller has a button in the back there too. Oh, it works! Once again, a totally different motor than the Xbox 360 controller, but. Oh, it looks like this one didn't auto bind. Probably because I don't have any auto binding set up yet for it. Okay, cool. Well, that works. Yay! It's working on three of my different controllers. That's great. But let's also see what ones this supports. This one supports, once again, square, triangle, and sine. Maybe that's just part of the way the driver works in Linux. Probably. All right, guys. Well, that's gonna be it for today's stream. I really appreciate you guys watching and all your support and feedback and suggestions and everything. So, I will be streaming probably tomorrow. And once again, thank you. I appreciate you. See you next time, everybody. Next time I'll have Controller Rumble working, at least on one platform. Yay! See ya.